भारतम् महाभारतम् धर्म अधर्म संघर्षणम्।
Utanka was of course happy that he had been able to fulfill the desire of his master's wife, but he was displeased with Takshaka who had harassed him. He had done Takshaka no harm, and yet the serpent king had harmed him. The recollection of this made Utanka angry. He resolved to punish Takshaka but could not decide how. At that time he learned that it was the same Takshaka who had bitten King Parikshit and killed him. Utanka now knew what to do. He bent his steps towards Hastinavati. King Janamejaya, the son of Parikshit, was ruling in Hastinavati at the time. Utanka arrived at his palace. He blessed the king and his courtiers who bowed to him. The king offered him a worthy seat. Utanka made inquiries about the welfare of all of them. He then said to the king, "Maharaja, haven't you forgotten the foremost of your duties?" Janamejaya was perplexed. "What? Have I failed in my duty? May I know which one, sire?" the king asked. Utanka continued, "King, have you avenged the untimely death of your father?" Janamejaya asked, "Be avenged on whom and why?" Utanka answered, "Janamejaya, although the ministers, generals and others were guarding your father with the utmost care, Takshaka evaded them all and brought about the death of your father, did he not? Should you not avenge yourself on him?" Janamejaya recalled the circumstances of his father's death and was deeply grieved. He was very angry with Takshaka. He said, "Rishi Kumara, I had forgotten my duty. You have reminded me. I am grateful to you. I wish to wipe out the very race of that Takshaka who killed my father. I pray to you, tell me how to do it." The court priest who was nearby said, "Maharaja, there is a sacrifice known as Sarpasatra. You can perform this sacrifice and offer serpents to the fire god." Janamejaya immediately sent for the priests who used to officiate at sacrifices. He told them, "I have decided to perform the Sarpayaga. Make necessary preparations." Utanka, greatly relieved, returned to his home. As they listened to the narration of Sauti, several questions occurred to the rishis of Naimisharanya. They said, "Holy sir, we have some doubts. Kindly clear them. Only Takshaka had troubled Utanka, and so he alone should have been punished. Instead, Utanka sought to exterminate the entire race of serpents. Was it proper for him to do so? Besides, once this sacrifice was performed, the race of serpents should have been entirely destroyed. But even now, a number of serpents exist. How did that happen?" Sauti replied, "Utanka's wrath was not the only cause of the extermination of serpents. Their mother herself had pronounced such a curse on them. Interestingly, Janamejaya did not complete the serpent sacrifice. That is why a number of serpents survived." The rishi said, "Sauti ji, your words have whetted our curiosity. Who was the mother of serpents? Why did she so curse her own children? And why did Janamejaya not complete his sacrifice? We pray you, tell us in detail." Sauti then began the story of the serpents. Prajapati Brahma had several daughters like Kadru and Vinata. When they came of age, Prajapati married some of them to sage Kashyapa. In course of time, Kadru gave birth to a number of children. These were serpents. The first of them, Adisesha bears the earth. Vinata had two sons, Aruna and Garuda. Aruna became the charioteer of the sun god. Garuda grew up to be of formidable prowess. He was the son of Vinata and therefore came to be called Vainateya. The gods and the Rakshasas churned the ocean of milk. One of the objects which rose from the ocean was Uchchaishravas, a great steed. The horse was white as milk and very attractive. Living beings came from the three worlds just to see the horse. Kadru and Vinata also wished to see the horse. They discussed the appearance of the horse. Vinata said, "It seems the horse is entirely white, without even a black spot." Kadru remarked, "How can that be? At least the tail must be black." Vinata said, "No, it seems even the tail is white." Kadru said, "That is impossible. Let us take a wager." When Vinata asked, "What will the wager be?" Kadru replied, "If the horse is entirely white, I shall be your servant for life. But if the tail is black, you will have to be my servant." Vinata agreed. The two decided to go and see the steed. What began as a light-hearted talk led to a momentous stake. Kadru, too, was not certain that the tail was black. Everyone was saying that the horse was totally white. But still, she went ahead because she wanted to defeat Vinata. From childhood, she had nurtured a sense of enmity towards Vinata. A perverse bravado had made her suggest the wager. She now wanted to win somehow or the other. She called the serpents, which were her children. A number of serpents like Sesha, Vasuki, Takshaka and Karkotaka came to her. She explained the conversation between Vinata and herself. She then said, "Go and cover the tail of the horse with your bodies. It will then appear black and I shall win." The serpents asked her, "Mother, is it right to cheat in this fashion?" Kadru was angry and said, "Do you talk back to me? May you all perish in a fire." Sad and frightened, the serpents went to where the horse was and clung to its tail as their mother had instructed. When Vinata and Kadru came to see the horse, only the tail was black. Vinata admitted defeat and became Kadru's servant. Since Vinata was Kadru's servant, her son Garuda too had to obey Kadru and her children. The serpents ill-treated Garuda as a menial. He was very unhappy. He wished to free himself and his mother somehow or the other. Garuda went to the serpents and asked them, "Tell me what I must do to free my mother." They recalled their mother's curse and said, "If you bring us Amrita from the world of the gods, you will both be free. If we drink Amrita, we will never die. Our mother's curse will become ineffective," so they thought. At once, Garuda soared to high in the sky. Beating his wide wings, he flew towards the world of the gods. He was as swift as the wind. Such was the force of his flight that huge mountains collapsed. Garuda went to the world of the gods so fast. The army of Devendra learnt that Garuda was on his way to carry away the Amrita. It swooped on him, but Garuda overcame the army in a trice. He carried the pot containing Amrita to the serpents and offered it to them. In this manner, he fulfilled the demand of the serpents and freed his mother. Mahavishnu was pleased with the swiftness of Garuda when he went to fetch the Amrita. He said to Garuda, "Be my Vahana." Garuda consented. Thus, Garuda became the vehicle of Vishnu. Serpents were worried about their mother's curse. Though Garuda had secured Amrita for them, Indra rushed to the spot and snatched it away from them. So, they did not have the Amrita to save them. They pondered over how to escape from the curse. A serpent, Ilapatra by name, said, "Let us find a suitable husband for our sister Jaratkaru. Her son will not belong to our race, and so our mother's curse will not hurt him. We can strive to avert the misfortune that haunts us." The serpents found a worthy husband for Jaratkaru. Surprisingly, his name was also Jaratkaru. Later, she gave birth to a son called Astika. Astika mastered all knowledge. Having narrated the story thus far, Ugrashrava Sauti said, "Everything is clear now, isn't it? Kadru's curse was the primary cause of the Sarpayaga. Utanka and Janamejaya were only the instruments." Then he returned to the story of serpent sacrifice performed by Janamejaya.